All right, in this video, I'm going to talk you about how to get GitHub Copilot and GitHub Pro for free if you are student and teachers. All right, so now you can see that I got my GitHub profile for free because I'm a student and as well as teacher as well. All right, so anyway, I'm just going to show you what all benefits you will be getting. GitHub Student Developer Pack. When you search GitHub Student Developer Pack or direct link is there in the description box, click on this particular thing. Now, this will give you a lot of features. For example, if you are a student, you get introduction to the open source, all these tools for free. I can't even tell you how many tools are there. I think there is like hundreds plus tools over here, which is completely free for you to get started with, right? So this is crazy. This is literally crazy over here. So what you need to do is like sign up for Student Developer Pack over here. Now, all right. So now, if you are a student, click on this. Student has a lot of features than being a teacher. For being a teacher, you'll be only getting GitHub Pro, GitHub Deep Masses, and you can apply for the Copilot as well. Now, being a student, you'll be getting all the package which I sent to you before. Now, once your student package is approved, when I was student, I approved that. It got approved, I think. It got expired right now, okay. All right, now you can see I'm currently using a pro version, and if you're a student, the first step is like apply for GitHub student benefit. Once your benefit is get approved, then you can apply for the GitHub campus expert, which I will be talking about in the next video by the time your GitHub student developer pack will be approved. So over here, there are a few criterias, which is like you should have a GitHub account and you should be 13 years old and you should be currently enrolled in any of the degree or diploma in your particular universities, and you should be able to provide some documentation related to how actually you can apply for the student developer pack. All right, so that's a few things which you need to be keep in mind, and also you should update your billing information by clicking over here. And I would say following any one of these would be great. You don't have to follow everything. I would say click on this verify academic email ID. So here you can go to your profile. For example, you can go to your profile and you can click on the settings and click on the emails. Here you will be able to see all the emails attached to your profile, and you should add your academic email ID over there. So I'm not showing you that one because I have my personal work email ID as well over there. So now you have to personalize your public GitHub profile photo and name of your thing. So that's the reason why I initially made a video on how to improve your GitHub profiles so you can eventually apply for the GitHub student developer pack. So if you are one person who watching this video for the first time, I created a couple of playlists on the GitHub playlist where I'm talking about how to create an achievements, how to do an organization, how to improve your overall profile look, and give you suggestion to use some particular platform where you can follow the same thing. So make sure that you do that so that would be easy for you to optimize. So now it says that generate a readme for your GitHub profile and customize with your interest and publish it where to see. So this, we also spoke about this thing, and I also shared you some link where you can go and literally explore what is this other people's profile and get some ideas from their profile and copy paste it in your profile as well. So link for this as well is given in the description box, and make sure that you follow me on the GitHub so you will be also able to see a lot of updates from me. Now coming back to the business. All right, so once you do this, make sure that you have at least 6 months old on your GitHub account. So once you've done this, select your university. So currently I'm studying in the Macquarie University. So you can select this school and click on the continue button. As I have already approved, I won't be able to show you the next account. So maybe in the next account, they will be asking you some details to upload your student ID card or your transcript. So make sure that in the student ID card or transcript, you do have a date mentioned, like when you joined and when that particular study period is getting over. So they only look for the date. If the date everything is over, within 1 hour, your account will get approved. Come back to this particular page and see whether it's approved or not. So once it get approved, you get all this information, like all the student developer pack along with the GitHub Pro for free. I mean, literally free. You have a lot of benefits out there, which you can go go and explore on GitHub dashboard. As you can see, this all you will get for free. Can you imagine like what else you can do with all this information and all this? You get Copilot, which is like around $10 per free, and you get Namecheap, which is like 1 year domain name registration for free. You get .tech domains for free for 1 year, and you have an option to do Heroku, GitLens. This is crazy. Like, you get a GitLens for 1 year, GitLens extension for this is crazy. Like, you get a pro license. This is crazy. And MongoDB, Visual Studio Code, DataCamp 3 months. This is like endless. So you have multiple options. So there is like long option that you should not stop learning. So this is like how GitHub is supporting you, and you get access to these things. So this is crazy in terms of how you see the things, and you get StreamYard as well. What else you need as a student? All right, so I hope you guys apply for this and get it approved. And if you face any issues, just tell in the comment box below. So that would be very helpful for me to help you to get this get approved. All right, in the next video, we're going to talk about what is GitHub Copilot and how you can embed in your particular code and how you can use it. By the now, you will be having a GitHub Copilot access, so you can get useful of the other information. Thank you for watching this video, and maybe next video, we will be talking about more about GitHub Copilot. Thank you.